obstinate, refuse to honor its commitments and its disrespect for the fundamental humanity rights and international law. Now I would like to invite Mr. Abdul Hakeem for English speech.
Mr. President, Soros have occupied Kashmir. Peace has gone. War has overhanded Kashmir. Love has gone. Every single thing reflects sadness. Every step perceived and succeeded with agonies of victim. Books ended, pens got dry, tears faded. But still, pain didn't stop. Its atmosphere turned black. Its air smelled sour. Land turned into burial places. No space left to roam freely. Mr. President, Jammu and Kashmir is a part of Pakistan. In blood, in flesh, in culture, in history, in geography. Kashmir is our lifeline, and we will always support our brothers and sisters' right to self-determination. Muhammad Rajna himself, who referred to Kashmir as the jugular vein of the country, the view of Qaid Azam is that Kashmir is the jugular vein of Pakistan, is a guiding principle for every Pakistani. Mr. President, the inauguration of Kashmiri's misfortune had been started since October 26, 1947, when a Eurasian Sheikh Abdullah left Kashmiris in trouble and joined hands with Indians for his interests. The tale of Kashmiri's injustice started from that time and is still continued after 74 years, and the genocide is going on there nowadays. What is going in Kashmir? Indian soldiers are butchering Muslims. They want to change the majority of Muslims in Kashmir into minority. They have turned its roses into thorns, thorns into stakes, pleasant nights into burning fire, joy into grief, health into sickness, mercy into wrath, life into death, and good fortune into misfortune. India has crossed all the limits and indicates that if we cannot react, the historian will certainly record that when India occupied Kashmir, we were only heading, we were only signing, we were only writing speeches, we were only protesting on the road, we were doing only tweets on the sky, set status on Facebook and WhatsApp, and arrange live press conferences. Words matter immensely. Now it is clear that this is not the solution of Kashmir, because Hindu cannot be convinced with words. Only sword can convince them and give them a lesson. Mr. President, the only solution to Kashmir problem is sword. Be it a guerrilla war, organized war, or a war through freedom fighters, it is established that pen cannot solve this problem now. Mr. President, my message and earnest appeal to Muslim leadership in Kashmir is organize your people educationally, socially, economically, and politically, and set your hand on constructive nation building programs. Stand united, work selflessly, perseveringly, and in a disciplined manner, and I assure you, no power on earth can prevent you from the attainment of Azad Kashmir and the realization of your just and legitimate rights. Sympathies are with you in your struggle, and I wish your session all success. Thank you for your time.
Azadi!